victims of slavery often don't self-identify as victims, and that's for several reasons. But they are reluctant to talk because they don't have support. They often don't have support mechanisms in place that facilitate the story sharing that leads to a prosecution. So the last trafficking slavery prosecution in Australia was 2013. Not because it hasn't happened since then, it has. But unfortunately, there was a recent case in WA where the traffickers got away with trafficking and the victims were repatriated back to their homes without any assistance or recognition of the crimes and violations against them. So the modern slavery bill is a step towards that realisation, but it needs to be supported through those practical mechanisms to facilitate the rehabilitation of women, particularly, and children. So what are some practical solutions? 10 years ago, I ran for Parliament and I didn't get in. I didn't realise that I'd spend more time in Parliament not being a member of Parliament today. 5 years ago, when I left government role as a lawyer, I didn't realise I'd be more involved in law reform than when I was in working in government as a lawyer. So lobbying and law reform is such an imperative part of shifting those social norms within Australia. So the top-down approach of understanding and setting those standards through law reform is imperative. But that's nothing if not equipped and coupled with the social reform. And education and outreach is such an integral part of that. So shifting people's understanding of an issue, you think about things like asbestos or smoking, health hazards that we know of today. At one time, were not recognised and understood as health hazards. And through education campaigns and awareness, these social norms shifted. And of course, it's the same for the demand for sex slavery. And so that's what I want to focus on here today, just in closing. Because the majority of the world's slaves are women and girls, predominantly trafficked into sexual servitude. And if they're not, they're often raped and abused in their state of slavery through other means. So when we think about causation and harm, and when we think about the root cause of any issue, it's important and imperative to address the root cause, otherwise the problem's still going to be there. We can write as much legislation as we want about modern slavery. If we're not real about why it's occurring, we're not going to address it. So first of all, acknowledging that Australia is a demand nation into this region is imperative. So as a developed nation, through sex tourism and through other means, we have created a demand for slavery into our region and into Australia. Secondly, understanding that demand behaviour in what forms and industries that it operates. And of course, unfortunately, the sex industry is overrepresented in relation to this matter. Melissa Farley, a world-renowned psychologist in this space who's done international studies on it, has cited 89% of the women that she has interviewed in brothels across the world, different countries, don't want to be there. 89% do not want to be there. But they're not provided with alternatives or exit pathways. But of course, when we understand and look at the causation of this, understanding the gender-based violent behaviours and sexual violent behaviours that underpin the thinking and the choices that are made is imperative. Education around gender-based and sexual violence is crucial. My last Law Journal report talks about 5-year-old children accessing harmful online material and acting out what they're seeing at school with their peers. This act harms not only the children involved, but it sets a really dangerous precedent in our society. understandings of healthy intimacy and relationship is thwarted. And so we need to reclaim this space. We need to reclaim the value of relationships that are healthy and based on consent. And we need to have a deeper understanding of that. And so education is one pathway towards that. So today your task is to take away with you our little flyer and the demand. And I want you to think about a principal you may know, a pastor, or a community worker that you know, who we could talk to about running an education program with their contacts as a form of prevention. Education as a form of prevention is powerful because it alerts people to make informed decisions and of course empowers them to make healthy decisions in their own lives. So partner with us and help us do that and see a shift in your community. The Australian government federally spends $21.8 billion a year on gender-based violence alone. The violence that is perpetrated in relationships needs to be addressed. But that, of course, does start with a supportive, healthy environment for men to feel safe to come and to talk about how to do that, what that might look like, and for men to support each other. I'm such a strong believer that men are part of the solution, if they choose to be. So we're inviting the men to be part of the solution, part of the answer to the slave trade in our country and in our region. Thank you. So again, please.